Hi students, now we are going to discuss a new chapter, coordinate geometry. Let us see something in introduction. There are all sorts of ways that we can find the measurements of lines and angles. We can use rulers to measure line and protractors to measure angles. In coordinate geometry, we can use graphs and coordinates to find measurements and other. This study was initially developed by the French philosopher and mathematician René Descartes. Here is an illustration. Let's start by reviewing the features of coordinates graph. A coordinate graph is a rectangular grid with two number lines called axes. That was shown in the figure. The x-axis is the horizontal number line and the y-axis is the vertical number line. The axes intersect at the origin, which is point 0, 0. Then, what is a Cartesian system? A Cartesian coordinate system is a coordinate system that specifies each point uniquely in a plane by a pair of numerical coordinates, which are the signed distance to the point from two fixed perpendicular directed lines measured in the same unit of length. Then, coordinate. Two mutually perpendicular lines meet at a point O and the lines are called coordinate. Then, origin. The horizontal line XOX dash is called the x-axis and vertical line YOY dash called y-axis and the called origin. Positive x-axis. The horizontal line to the right of the origin is called the positive x-axis. Then negative x-axis. The horizontal line to the left of the origin is called the negative x-axis. Then positive y-axis. The vertical line above the origin is called the positive y-axis. Then negative y-axis. The vertical line below the origin is called the negative y-axis. That was shown in the figure. Let us see quadrants. The axis, that's the plural of the word axis, that divide the plane into four parts. These four parts are called the quadrants. That was numbered 1, 2, 3 and 4 in the figure, anti-clockwise from OX. So the plane consists of the axis and these quadrants. We call the plane the Cartesian plane or the coordinate plane or the XY plane. The axes are called the coordinate axes. Then abscissa. The X coordinate of a point is its perpendicular distance from the Y axis measured along the X axis. That is positive along the positive direction of the x-axis and negative along the negative direction of the x-axis. For the point P, it is positive 4 and for Q, it is negative 6. The x-coordinate is also called the abscissa. That was shown in the figure. Ordinate. The y-coordinate of a point is its perpendicular distance from the x-axis measured along the y-axis, which is positive along the positive direction of the y-axis and negative along the negative direction of the y-axis. For at the point P, it is positive 3 and for Q, it is negative 2. The y-coordinate is also called the ordinate axis, which is shown in the figure. Relationship between points and sign. If a point is in the first quadrant, then the point will be in the form positive, comma, positive. Since the first quadrant is enclosed by the positive x-axis and the positive y-axis. If a point is in the second quadrant, then the point will be in the form of negative, comma, positive. Since the second quadrant is enclosed by the negative x-axis and the positive y-axis. If a point is in the third quadrant, then the point will be in the form of negative, comma, negative. Since the third quadrant is enclosed by the negative x-axis and the negative y-axis. If a point is in the fourth quadrant, then the point will be in the form of positive, comma, negative. Since the fourth quadrant is enclosed by the positive x-axis and the negative y-axis. That was shown in the figure. Then, what is ordered pair? Two numbers written in a certain order, usually written in parentheses like this, 4, 5, which can be used to show the position on a graph, where the x, which denotes horizontal value, is first, and the Y. That shows vertical, that is value is second. Here the point 12,5 is 12 units along and 5 units up in the figure. Let us see an example. Locate the points 5,0, 0,5, 2,5, 5,2, -3,5, -3, -5, 5, -3 and 6,1 in the Cartesian plane. So we are going to solve the problem. First, taking 1 centimeter equal to 1 unit, we draw the x-axis and the y-axis. The positions of the points are shown by dots in figure. In the example above, you see that 5,0 and 0,5 are not at the same position. Similarly, 5,2 and 2,5 are at different positions. Also, -3,5 and 5,-3 are at different positions. By taking several such examples, you will find that if x not equal to y, then the position of xy in the Cartesian plane is different from the position of y, x. So, if we interchange the coordinates x and y, the position of y, x will differ from the position of x, y. This means that the order of x and y is important in x, y. Therefore, x, y is called an ordered pair. The ordered pair x, y, which is not equal to ordered pair of y, x. If x not equal to y, also x, y, which is equal to y, x, if x is equal to y. Let us summarize. To locate the position of an object or a point in a plane, we require two perpendicular lines. One of them is horizontal and the other is vertical. The plane is called the Cartesian or coordinate plane and the lines are called the coordinate axis. The horizontal line is called the x-axis and the vertical line is called the y-axis. The coordinate axis divide the plane into four parts called quadrants. The point of intersection of the axis is called the origin. The distance of a point from the y-axis is called its x-coordinate or abscissa. And the distance of the point from the x-axis is called its y-coordinate or ordinate. If the abscissa of a point is x and the ordinate is y, then xy are called the coordinates of the point. The coordinates of a point on the x-axis are of the form x, o and that of the point on the y-axis are o, y. The coordinates of the origin are 0, 0. The coordinates of a point are of the form positive, positive in the first quadrant, negative, positive in the second quadrant, negative, negative in the third quadrant and positive, negative in the fourth quadrant, where positive denotes a positive real number and negative denotes a negative real number. If x not equal to y, then x, y, which is not equal to y, x and x, y, which is equal to y, x if x equal to y. Thank you.